From the station that made country music famous, 650 AM WSM, this is a Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast.
Hi, it's Charlie Maddison. In this episode, we sit down with Grand Ole Opry star Chris Young. His new single, If That Ain't God. We talk about the inspiration for that. We talk about playing the Grand Ole Opry during the pandemic and a whole lot more. Enjoy our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast as we Zoom with Chris Young.
Oh, if that ain't God, if that ain't God, I don't know what is. Yeah.
AM WSM, that is brand new from Chris Young, If That Ain't God. Coffee, Country, and Cody, we are Zooming with Chris Young, and good morning, my friend, and I guess the place to start is that song. I'm curious, around before the pandemic, or was it all kind of inspired by what we've been going through the last few months?
So actually, this is a bit of a different situation for me. One, the song got sent to me during, pretty much everyone quarantining at home. So happened right in the middle of all this. Also, originally, I was not a writer on this song. This was Mitchell Oglesby, Graylin James, and Matt Roy. And they sent it to me. I really loved the song, and I kind of reached out to them. I was like, hey, you know, I know messing with a song is like messing with someone's baby, but I'd really like to rewrite the chorus and, like, maybe change a line or two in the verses. And they were really gracious in allowing me to do that. And then they decided to add me on as a writer as well. So that was something they did not have to do. I kind of told them, I was like, I'm already cutting the song. Like, this this is not required. But they said that they wanted to do that. So really, really cool of them to do that. And, got a chance to produce this one with Chris DiStefano, which he and I have known each other for a long time. A lot of people know who he is. We had not co-produced anything, even though we had talked about doing it for a long time. And, this all got tracks during lockdown, you know, while everybody was staying at home, and kind of did everything digitally. Chris played most of the parts because he's just that annoyingly talented and really kind of ticks me off with the fact that he can just, like, teach himself to play fiddle if he feels like it. But we worked together on this one, got it sung, turned it into the label, teased it online, fans loved it, and it just kind of all fell into place. So very, very different way, start to finish, of this song coming into my life and being what it is. But, you know, an incredibly special song, and really glad that it's the single.
Well, it is that for sure. Incredibly special. Available anywhere you can download or stream music, If That Ain't God, from Chris Young. So take us back, May the 20th. An empty Grand Ole Opry House, you, Chris Jansen, Brett Young, everybody we have talked to who has done one of those shows has just kind of used the word surreal. Is that does that work for you? Is that an accurate adjective?
Yeah, I mean, I think we all acknowledge that it was something that is very odd. As many times as I've played, not just the Opry, but in the Opry House, the three of us and everybody being spread out and, you know, doing everything that we need to do to adhere to social distancing protocols and make sure everybody's being safe. But so odd being in that space and not having anyone there to give you that reaction. That's such a part of, you know, what the history of the Opry is. That's the longest running show like that for a reason. I mean, it is that kind of transmission, not only the airwaves, but of what's going on stage and that interaction between the crowd and the artists. So very surreal, very different, but also so incredibly honored to be a part of one of those and so excited that they're still continuing to find a way to make them work. Because I do think that that is something that gives everybody a sense of normalcy somewhat, even though it is surreal and it's different, it's still music. It's still music from the stage of the Grand Ole Opry. And I think that's important.
Yeah, well, sense of normalcy is a great way to phrase that. And speaking of normal, I know a lot of artists are trying to get back into something resembling normal. We've seen social distancing shows. We've seen drive-in shows. Are you thinking about getting back out on the road at all, even on a limited basis? Is that part of the current plan?
right now, it just for me, it's not. And I know there's a lot of different ways that people are looking at trying to make their show work in the parameters that we're kind of given right now. But seeing as they keep going forwards and backwards, depending on what city they're in or what state they're in, you know, a couple months ago, everybody was like, you should go play in this state because they're pretty much wide open. And now some of those states have, you know, stepped back several phases. And I just think for me, after I got to a point where I was like, hey, we're going to cancel this summer tour so that people aren't constantly going, is it going to happen? Is it not going to happen? Are we going to have to like cap it somewhere else? Or how are we going to do refunds? You know, everybody's also as much as I want to get back to work, there's a lot of people that fall into that category right now. And a lot of people that, you know, probably can't afford to buy a ticket to a show right now. So I think the best thing for safety and for everything else that's going on, without having to, you know, kind of hope that I can play some stuff and then maybe have to back it off again and have to go back and forth with that, for right now in the level of venues that we've been playing, I say we, me and my band and a lot of other people that are in kind of my level of touring, is to just cancel it, wait it out and see where it is. There's going to be some stuff that pops up that we're going to be able to do, like, you know, obviously the performance at the Opry. You look at what Brad Paisley and Darius and John did this past weekend, where they kind of had a one-off weekend where they did the big drive-in kind of show. But that's not going to be able to fully replace the level of touring that we were doing in our summers. I mean, it's not going to be the same. So for me, I'm kind of waiting and trying to give it a little bit more time before, you know, we really see what's going to work for safety for everybody, because that's the most important thing.
Well, 2020 has been a rough year for a lot of folks, and the music industry has certainly been hit with a lot of losses. Kenny Rogers, Joe Diffie, of course, John Prine, Charlie Daniels most recently. And I know you and Charlie got to be pretty close over the last few years. Just some thoughts on the life that was Charlie Daniels.
Anytime someone gets to give their acceptance speech into the Hall of Fame, you know, that says a lot about the level of artist you're speaking of. And then when you go and ask anyone about Charlie Daniels, even before he passed, the very first thing they're going to say is how selfless he is and how much, you know, he gives to the military charities that he's been involved with, other artists that he's met over the years, just being an inspiration for them, always having time to say hello to somebody. When you look at the level and the longevity of a career that someone like that has had, and then you realize that the very first thing that's most often spoken about Charlie Daniels is what a great man he is. And now, sadly, what a great man he was. That says a whole lot about somebody. That's something that I would aspire to as a human. And, you know, we lost a lot. We lost a lot more than just a great musician. We lost a great man. And I was lucky enough to get a chance to know him. And not only through music, but also through charity work that he's done with the military, and just, you know, see the level of joy he brought to people through music, and see the level of, you know, hope and happiness he brought to people, not only through that, but also through his charitable giving and his works that he did that sometime went not unnoticed, but not as noticed, I think, is some of the musical accomplishments that he had. So definitely sad that he had passed away.
That's Chris Young. If you just joined us, we are Zooming with Chris. The new single is called If That Ain't God. I'm going to leave you on this note. You know, and if you work in the music business or radio long enough, you know numbers. So when I knew we were going to chat, I mean, I knew 11 number ones, and I knew the gold and the platinum albums. But when I was looking at some of the stuff that Cindy had sent over and saw 2 billion streams, I was like, billion? No, that can't be right. And then I started doing the math, and it's crazy. So how do you wrap your head around a number like 2 billion?
Yeah, it's wild, and it is mind-blowing, but it's also very humbling and very much something that I don't take for granted. You know, that's one of the other things that's been kind of a symptom, I guess. You probably don't want to use the word symptom. A side effect of, you know, staying home so much this year, and being in a situation where I'm not out touring, is you start thinking about different things. And just looking at the career that I've had just up to this point, you know, I just turned 35 this year, and the things that I've been able to accomplish and been able to put up on the wall and put on a plaque over the course of my career so far has just been incredible. So not taking any of that for granted whatsoever.
Chris Young on Coffee, Country, and Cody. Thank you for your time. We appreciate your friendship. Can't wait to see you back in studio. Zooming with Chris Young this morning on Coffee, Country, and Cody.
Thanks for listening to our Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast. Our program director at WSM Radio is J. Patrick Tittle. Our digital producer is Haley Hall. Marketing and promotions director is Amanda Cannon. And I'm Charlie Mattis. If you like what you've heard, make sure you subscribe so you never miss an episode. And leave us a review on iTunes. It really does help new people find the show.